So it kind of seems that everyone is going into the payment space these days, and with the different cards available, there are always two different camps. The first camp that we have is the cashback camp, and the second one is the miles camp. And like my wife always pitches or sells the idea to me that cashback is like instant gratification,
But I only like gratification when it's instant.
while miles is a bit of a delayed gratification because you can accumulate those miles and then convert them into a business or a first class flight for a holiday. But that's not very attractive to me because I'm a cashback person, and although it's instant gratification, I feel that there's more use of that cashback. And recently I signed up for the Tiger Boss debit card, which functions like a cashback card, but has the novelty of allowing you to earn fractional shares as you spend. And as of recording, I've not used the card yet because we kind of just got it, but I will drop in updates while I start using it on my holidays or my work trips. So in the payment space, there are two different cards here, which is a debit card and a credit card. So both of these cards are quite a bit different, and here is the difference. If you look at credit cards, which only banks can offer, the banks are able to earn from card holders if they do not make prompt payments from their credit. And this is the interest that the banks earn, which can range anywhere between 24% to 36% depending on the bank. But with debit cards, there must be money in it before you can use it for payments. And more often than not, there is no real benefit other than enabling users to pay digitally as opposed to using cash. So probably one of the benefits that I like about a debit card is security, because you need to top up your card before you can start using it. And this can tremendously help you with overseas payments because merchants can only charge as much as the card has, which kind of puts a limit to how much money you're gonna lose in the event of fraud or mischarges or whatever else. So if you look at the Tiger Boss debit card, the features are pretty basic, like what most debit cards have from different fintechs. So we got competitive FX conversions, which I will try out very soon on my holiday. We have a free card application, and that's more or less what other card providers can provide as well. But something that really stood out or made me apply for it, other than just curiosity, is the feature that you get a 1% cashback in the form of Tesla shares. So basically, there's a long list of items that are not considered eligible spends, like your wire transfers, your utilities, your parking, hospital, donations, government service, and etc. But I took some time to look through the list and to look for potential things that we can pay for with this card to help us earn some Tesla shares. So for very regular things like your retail shopping, your transportation, and your dining, all these will qualify as eligible spending. So now let's talk about how the Tiger Boss debit card works. So the Tiger Boss debit card has a pretty simple mechanics that allows you to instantly start earning Tesla shares once you start spending. So first and foremost, you need to get a card for sure, and links will be in the description down below where you can apply for this card. So once you receive your card, it's as simple as topping up the card via the Tiger Broker app under the profile page where you hit on debit card. And over here, you can tap on the top up button and you can select between topping up via your Prime account, which is your brokerage account, or the available cash that you have in your trading account, or you can top up with a linked bank account. Then we can key in the amount that we want, and the amount is almost instantly deposited. So if you go back to the debit card page, you can see that the cashback that we have earned and how much we can redeem. So this is still pretty new to me, but I will try once the opportunity arises. So as simple as it sounds, here are some of my thoughts about the Tiger Boss debit card. I feel that the card is a cool way of gamification for people who are looking to invest but are always a little bit more hesitant. So now with the card, once you do make a spend, a small amount is put aside for you, which can be converted into shares. In a way, you can see it like an automated investing, but you need to make those claims yourself. So what I really hope Tiger Brokers can do, or can be an upgrade for a version 2, is to allow us, the users, to pick and choose which stocks we want to convert to. So for example, I might not want to convert my cashback into Tesla stocks because of how volatile it is, but it can be good for someone who's looking for short-term gains. But if I wanted maybe a different stock, maybe like VOO, or maybe I would like STI ETF, and if there's an option for me to pick, I think that would be great because this allows me to grow my portfolio with the stocks that I prefer holding. And the next feature that I would like to see is a credit function, or a credit feature where we can potentially collateralize our portfolio, and it gives us a credit limit on how much we can spend. So not sure how the implementation here might work on the tech side, but I think this will be something cool to have. So that's more or less my two major thoughts about the Tiger Boss debit card. I will be doing some testing for sure and spending it as I go on my daily life and see how things can work out for me.
So it's editing Jordan here right now. I'm actually editing the video halfway. It's pretty cool actually if you want to take a look. Like, there's myself there, we're editing it right now. And I just wanted to drop an update because we have been using the Tiger Boss debit card for a while. I used it in Malaysia as well to buy some water, some groceries on my cycling trip that I did. I'll put all those stats on this part of the screen here. So something I noticed is that there is a bit of a conversion fee. The conversion fee is pretty okay. I paid, I think it was like $1 to like 350 Malaysia ringgit. I think that was great. But I also noticed like a 1 cent conversion fee every time when I paid for something in Malaysia ringgit. I'm not sure if it happens to other currencies as well, but it happens for Malaysia from my experience so far. But then again, I think 1 cent is pretty okay. It doesn't really break the bank. I mean, if you do larger transactions, I think it's a lot more worth it. For me, I just bought some bottle of water for my trip, and I think it's pretty okay. So far, that's my experience with the card. I think it's pretty cool. You know, no big hiccups, just gonna top up once in a while. But yeah, I'll hand it back to the past me to finish up this video, and I really appreciate you guys for supporting me all this while.
So if you've enjoyed this video, hitting the like button and subscribe will help us a lot. And as always, if you have any questions, please let me know.